do some people betray others? Well, you are betrayed, I am betrayed, others are betrayed because we are not alert. We are weak-minded. We are not so active. We are not so dynamic. We are not alert, aware and awake. Since we are not alert, since we are not aware, since we are not awake, we are betrayed. So let us have these three A's. Awake, aware and alert, so that you will never be betrayed. That is the solution to this. The question is, why do we suffer when our families betray us? When you are betrayed by your family or by others, it is your fault. You are not conscious of what is happening. You are not understanding why people are behaving like that. What is the ultimate motive behind them? Be that family or the community. Understanding is not there. We are not able to understand how people are acting, how people are behaving. This kind of absence of awareness, not understanding people, that leads to betrayal. So it is my fault. It is not the other man who betrays me. I have allowed myself to be betrayed by him. Why should I allow myself to be betrayed? Why can't I be cautious? Why can't I be aware? Why can't I be careful? So it's my fault. Let me not blame the betrayer. Let me blame the betrayed for having allowed himself to be betrayed. That's what I think. Thank you. Well, the next question. Why have many of the devotees around the world lost confidence in their own religious organization? My friend, answer is simple. Organization is only a means but not an end. When once the means take you to the end, you are not bothered anything about anything. Simple example. You got the car. The car will take you to the destination. When once you reach the destination, you don't need the car anymore. So organization is only a motivation, is only a helper, is only a guide, but not an end to itself. But there are people who are so involved in organization, they consider that organization end to itself. No. Organization will help you to some extent. Thereafter, you have to work for yourself. Udared atma atmanam. You have to work for your liberation. You have to work for your redemption. You have to work for emancipation. Organization will not help you. Organization only a means, that's all, but not an end by itself. Therefore, people lost confidence in organization because they depend on the organization but not on the organizer. Who is the organizer? God Himself, the organizer. The rest of the people constitute an organization. So let us turn to God. Then this organization will become secondary. God is primary. Organization is secondary. The organization should lead us towards God. But if I limit myself to the organization, I am deeply soaked in it. I am totally engrossed with organizational activity. When the organization takes the primary role, God becomes secondary. I am away from Him. Let me constantly remind myself every second that God is primary, organization is secondary. Organization is a means, God is the end. That's what we have to be alert That's what we have got to be aware every minute of our life. Why are the leaders of these religious organizations around the world betray their devotees? I blame the devotees. I don't blame the leaders. You have allowed yourself to be betrayed. You have allowed yourself to be cheated by them. Therefore, they cheat you, they betray you. Leaders are not important. The principles of the organization, the aim of the organization, the purpose of the organization is primary. Leaders are only instruments, that's all. Leaders are there only to lead you, but not to betray you. If they betray you, they are not leaders at all. Be away from such people. Be away from such organization led by betrayers. So, we have to blame ourselves, not the leaders. And the leaders, they may betray you. It is my fault to be swayed, to be carried away by those betrayers. So, be away from such people. Thank you. What do these devotees who have lost faith in the religious organizations need to do when the leaders of the religious organization go against the teachings of their own religion? Very simple. What did Swami say? Cheja durjana samsargam. Run away from the bad company. Bhaja sadhu samagamam. Be in good company. Be in the good company. Run away from the bad company. If the leaders do not practice the religious principles of the organization, of the teachings of Bhagavan, take it, that's bad company. Let us run away from them. Let us join those who are pious, who practice Baba's teachings, that is good company, satsang. So, a leader is no leader if he does not practice the teachings of Bhagavan or teachings of any religion. If I don't follow biblical teachings, I cannot be a Christian. If I do not follow the teachings of Buddha, I am not a Buddhist. Therefore, let us be in the company of those who practice, not simply the leadership that has no faith in the teachings, that do not practice the teachings of Baba. That's what I feel about it. Thank you. Why do those who betray their religious organization have no shame? What is their karma? Because they are shameless, they betray. If they have sense of shame, they will never betray. And what is their karma? They will face their karma. Every karma will have reaction. Every action will have reaction. They will face the karmic effects. They cannot be free from the law of karma. So let us leave it to them, to their destiny, to their fate. Let us be away from such people. So those that betray their organization have no sense of shame. They are shameless. Be very clear about it. Thank you. What should devotees do when they know that leaders who run the religious organization have betrayed them? Disconnect yourself with the organization. Disconnect. When you are betrayed, when you are cheated, why should you continue in the organization? Come on, get out of it. Get out of it. This is seen in the biography, in the lives of Sri J. Krishnamurti, whom we fondly call Jiddu Krishnamurti, who just left Theosophy, Theosophical Lodge. I've got nothing to do it. And he lived himself and he has become a Jagat Guru, a master. So when we don't like it, you are free to get out of it. Why be in it? and just blame yourself. Why? Get out of it. That's what we can do. So, let us be cautious. Let us be aware of the betrayers. There are many people that betrayed many noble people. Well, what have they done? They left them, that's all. Let us leave them and guard ourselves. That is what we have to do. Thank you very much. This is from Satya. Always I think why people should not do puja when someone passes away in their family, either direct family or member or in their family tree. This is a wrong concept, a wrong notion. When any person dies, we should offer puja more. The attitude of worship now is more for the departed. We pray for the peace. Let the soul rest in peace. We do puja when one person departs from us, thanking God for the gift of his life, for this gift of the life, the departed, from whom we have learnt many things, from whom we received help in every way. This is gratitude. Puja, when anyone leaves you, is an act of gratitude, is an act of thankfulness. So it is all the more necessary. But we should understand, other times we do puja for our own good. When anyone near dear passes away, we pray for the peace of the departed soul. Thank God for the gift of that person who helped us as a matter of gratitude. So, leaving puja on the day when anyone leaves you is ignorance. Let us not fall into that ignorance. Thank you.